Hello folks, Jacob here. Today we're discussing 3.10.2, of which just hit the persistent universe. Now, there hasn't been a database reset. However, from what I can see, there is a lot more known issues compared to before. It seems that they've broken more things than they've fixed. Some of these, actually a couple of them, were already broken, but that's all well and good. There have been some feature updates, of which have been very much needed, and the bug fixes are quite good indeed. So moving on to the known issues recently added to this list. Moving from EVA to gravity in ships may damage or kill a player. I'm sure that's been present for some time. Rest stop may become duplicated, causing multiple hangar doors that will not open. Purchased weapon magazines don't appear in the Moby Glass. Okay. Hangar doors may close too quickly. That's fine. That happens. Missiles / torpedoes only hit one shield face. It's kind of interesting. Drake Herald HUD uses the old HUD system. Who uses the Herald? But whatever. When flying the Prowler in atmosphere and pitching the nose downwards, the ship can flip 180 degrees and be facing the opposite direction. Interesting. I kind of want to experience that. NPCs may stand on seats throughout the PU. Really? I'm sure I've not heard that issue before. Current balance displayed in the bottom right of the Moby Glass does not update after making transactions. I mean, I'm sure we'll figure a way around that. It's all well and good. Quantum and hydrogen fuel values are incorrectly the same in the refueling interface. That is interesting. I have noticed that over the last several days. That's just in the live version, not in the PTU variants that they've had recently. Players can lose sound in the arena commander. Okay. Player unequips armor / weapons, utilities, and saves changes. Whatever was unequipped will no longer be available in the PMA until the PMA is reopened. The elevator panel character. Okay, yeah. Most of these, the rest of these are all known issues, so that's all well and good. Now, an incredible feature update that they've added, or they've amended, is increasing the legal delivery mission rewards. I'm not sure off the top of my head how much that was. They say they've increased the legal ones. The illegal ones were 6,000, so I'm under the impression they're not more than 6,000, maybe 5, I guess. Not good enough, in my opinion. And now the bug fixes. Ships purchased in the game should now be saved correctly to long-term persistence. This is very good indeed, because that's obviously the problem with 3.10.1. Well done. Ships should no longer spawn in a flight-ready state when a player logs back into the ship's bed. Fine. Okay. Fixed an issue that allowed players to sell one SCU of cargo indefinitely when it is placed in a ship that is within another ship. Interesting bug, but I've been made aware of that. IFCS should no longer lower ship velocity while using a HOTAS when a player uses interaction mode or opens their Moby Glass. Now that's a bug that I did read about, and it was partially fixed and then fixed a bit more, which is all well and good. Derelict recovery missions that take place around Microtech should no longer send the user to deliver the box to Area 18. I've seen this and I've read about this. Character eyes should no longer appear large in certain goggles in the universe. Okay, seen that. And of course the technical things, fixed one client crash, 3 server crashes, a memory leak, and a GPU memory usage issue. Those 4 in which are very good indeed. So I personally look forward to experiencing that. Thank you ever so much for watching. Today's video sponsor is the like button for the glorious YouTube algorithm. That will of course allow this channel to grow with your support. Obviously don't forget to comment or subscribe. If you aren't already aware, I generally upload daily, so be sure to check back. My name is Jacob, thank you, and goodbye for now.